Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Patrick Sol, and I'm the East Asia correspondent for the Swiss newspaper Neue Zürcher Zeitung. Today is National Disaster Prevention Day of Japan, and we have the Minister of State for Disaster Management. He started his day very early today for disaster preparedness drill. But he's here today in another function. Keiji Furuya wears different hats, and he will most of all talk to us about the abduction issue. As you all know, the negotiations with North Korea have been going on. North Korea is supposed to submit a first report within probably the next few weeks. There's no exact date for that. And that's what Furuya-san is going to talk to us today. But in the question and answer session, you're free to ask any question you like, as usual. Before I forget it, Takamatsu-san is our translator. We have a short 10-15 minute speech by the minister, and then we go straight into the question and answer. Please.
拉致問題担当大臣の古谷圭一でございます。今日はこの外国人特派員協会でこのような形で私がお話をさせていただく機会を作っていただきました。世界に日々情報を発信をされる影響力のある皆様方でございます。心から感謝を申し上げたいと思います。
Hello, I've just been introduced. My name is Keiji Furuya, and I am the state minister in charge of the abduction issue. I would like to begin by expressing my great appreciation to the FCCJ for giving me this opportunity to speak before you today. I know that every day you send messages about Japan to the world. I know that you are a very influential group of persons. I thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity.
私は拉致問題担当大臣のほかに、国家公安委員長、そして防災担当大臣、あるいは国土強靭化担当大臣、これは初代の大臣でございますが、4つ務めておりますが、共通点があります。それは国によるリスクマネジメントを担当しているということです。
I believe that you know that I'm in charge of, the MC has said, various hats. I am not only the state minister in charge of the abduction issue, I am in charge of national public face safety, also disaster prevention, and also building a resilient nation. Actually, in regard to the last post, I am the first state minister to have this responsibility. I believe that these are four different responsibilities, but they have one thing in common, which is that they are all very concerned with risk management for the nation.
それではまずこの拉致問題について今日のテーマでございます。お話をさせていただきたいと思います。北朝鮮による日本人の拉致は1970年代から80年代にかけて、北朝鮮による拉致の疑いが持たれる失踪事件が日本国内や海外で発生をいたしました。
So I would like to move on to my main topic of today, which is the abduction issue. As many of you know, in the 1970s and 1980s, many persons of Japanese nationality began to become missing. They disappeared in parts of Japan and also in other parts of the world. And they were suspected of being abducted by the DPRK government.
1987年の11月に大韓航空機の爆破事件がございましたが、この実行犯である北朝鮮工作員キム・ヒョンヒと言いますが、彼女がですね、日本人拉致被害者から日本語その他日本の教育を受けたという証言の事案がございました。
In 1987, in November, I think many of you may remember the incident where Korean Airlines plane was crashed. There was an explosion and there was a crash, and one of the perpetrators was a North Korean spy, a woman named Kim Hyun Hui. Interrogated, she admitted that she had been taught the Japanese language and received a Japanese education from people who were abducted, Japanese people who were abducted by North Korea.
日本政府は1991年から始まりました日朝国交化正常化の場を含めて あらゆる機会に北朝鮮に対して、拉致問題を提起をしてきましたが、北朝鮮は一貫してこの拉致問題の実行を否定してきました。
Since that time, the Japanese government has taken every possible opportunity, whenever it has had an opportunity to meet with the North Korean representatives, to bring up the abduction issue. Beginning in 1991, the two governments began working level meetings to try to normalize relationships between the two nations. Each time, however, that the abduction issue was raised by the Japanese side, the DPRK denied that such an activity had ever taken place.
状況が大きく変わったのは2002年の9月、当時の小泉総理が訪朝したときです。日朝首脳会談において、当時の北朝鮮の最高指導者であったキム・ジョン・イルが、日本人拉致を初めて公式に認め、謝罪をしました。
Things took a dramatic turn in September of 2002. This is when Prime Minister Koizumi actually flew to the DPRK, and during the summit meeting with his counterpart, Mr. Kim Jong-il, who was of course the top leader of North Korea at that time. During the summit meeting, Mr. Jong-il for the first time officially recognized that the abductions had taken place, and he officially apologized.
北朝鮮側が生存しているとした5名の被害者は最終的にその家族も、帰国をいたしました。しかし12名のその他の政府認定被害者については北朝鮮は8名を死亡とし、4名は北朝鮮へ入境をしていないというふうに言明をいたしました。
In regard to this summit meeting, the North Korean government took a further step and said that there were five survivors, in other words, five abductees who were still remaining in North Korea. Eventually, these five persons were returned to Japan along with their families. However, at that time, the Japanese government had officially identified 12 other abductees. And of these abductees, the North Korean government took the position that eight had died over the intervening years, and four, there were no records of them having ever entered the country.
しかし、この点について何ら、信じられる、証拠は提出していません。北朝鮮に、による説明がいかに信憑性の欠くものであるということについてはお手元に今日資料を配っております。その資料をパンフレットをご覧ください。
However, no credible evidence, no concrete evidence, no credible explanation was ever given to support these statements. In fact, we have distributed to you this pamphlet, which shows you some of the evidence that was presented by the North Korean side and why we believe that this evidence cannot be believed.
具体的には、例えば死亡したとした人間については、偽物の骨を、提供したり、この偽物の骨は日本の DNA の最高技術によって偽物であるということを判明をさせました。
As an example of the reasons for why we feel very skeptical with the evidence that they presented, we were presented with some remains, some bones that were supposedly from one of the abductees who died. However, when we took the top high-tech technology available in Japan to do DNA testing, it was discovered that these bones were not the abductees' bones at all.
それから死亡診断書も、偽物であるということが判明をいたしました。
We also did an investigation and saw that the and realized that the death certificates were fabricated. They were not to be believed.
ここで重要なのは北朝鮮がこのような証拠までも出してこざるを得なかったこと自体が拉致被害者がまだ生存していることの証であるということが言えると思います。
The important thing that I would like to emphasize here is that we believe that the reason that we believe that the fact that the North Korean government has had to produce this kind of fabricated evidence is actual proof that these abductees are still alive.
政府認定拉致被害者は17名でございますが、その他に北朝鮮による拉致の疑いを、排除できない事案、我が国の警察は、こうした行方不明者として、 860人の方をリストアップをいたしております。
I've mentioned earlier that there were 17 abductees that have been officially recognized by the government, Japanese government as abductees. However, there are other persons who are suspected of having been abducted by the DPRK. In other words, the possibility that they were abducted cannot be completely dismissed or ruled out. Actually, our police agency has identified 860 such persons.
私たちはこの安倍内閣になったときにこの860名の方がいらっしゃるということを、昨年の春に正式に公表いたしました。
Actually, after Prime Minister Abe's administration came into power last spring, we first officially released this number, 860 persons, to the general public.
ちなみに家族の同意を得てホームページに公開をしていいという了解をいただいて各都道府県警察そして警察庁のホームページに掲載をしている方は日々増えておりまして現在で443名いらっしゃいます。
And of these 860 persons, we are, have actively approached the remaining families of these persons, and we have received permission from 443 persons' families to list the information about the missing person on the homepage of the National Police Agency and also on the homepages of all of the regional or local police agencies as well.
日本政府の拉致問題に対する方針は政府認定の有無にかかわらず全ての拉致被害者を取り戻すというのが明確な方針であります。
The administration of Prime Minister Abe has taken a very, very clear policy, which is that regardless of whether a person has been officially designated as an abductee, for all of these missing persons, the government is resolved, determined to ensure that they are all able to return safely to Japan.
安倍内閣のこの拉致問題に対する取り組みについて説明をいたします。
I would now like to explain specifically what initiatives the Abe administration has undertaken in this regard.
日本政府の基本的立場は拉致問題解決のためまず全ての拉致被害者の安全確保および即時の帰国2つ目、拉致問題に関する真相究明3つ目、実行犯の引き渡しこの3点です。
I will be very, very specific about what the Japanese government's fundamental stance on this matter is. We have three things that we must ensure, we must realize. First of all, we want to secure the safety and the immediate return to Japan of all of the abductees. Secondly, we want to conduct investigations to determine the truth or facts of this abductee issue. And thirdly, we want to ensure that the perpetrators, the people who actually were involved in the abductions, are extradited.
安倍内閣が成立後、この目的達成のために国内体制の強化を速やかに行いました。
After Prime Minister Abe administration was established under his leadership, we have immediately moved to take different measures to ensure that this abductee issue is resolved.
Excuse me. 政府拉致問題対策本部の強化を行いました。前の政権では、この拉致対策本部は総理大臣ほか一部の閣僚のみから構成をされていましたが、すべての閣僚が構成員となりました。
Specifically, in regard to domestic initiatives, we immediately enhanced what this organization called the headquarters for the abduction issue that is part of the government of Japan. This headquarters for the abduction issue was an existing, pre-existing organization or part of the government. However, previously, the only members were the prime minister and several specific members of the cabinet. Under Prime Minister Abe's leadership, however, every member of the cabinet is a member of this headquarters.
この対策本部のもとに政府与野党拉致問題対策拉致問題対策機関連絡協議会というですね与党のみならず野党もメンバーになった協議会を官邸の中に作ったということがこれは明治ともにオールジャパンで解決するという強いメッセージでもあろうと思います。
Not only that, under the headquarters, we have established another organization, which is called the Liaison Council of Government and Ruling and Opposition Parties Institutions for Measures Against Abduction Issues. That's a very long title. It means that this is a group that is composed of not only members of the ruling party, but also the opposition parties as well. And this is a group that meets inside the cabinet office. In other words, this is a very, very clear message that we consider this matter to be an all Japan issue.
国際社会に対しても積極的な取り組みを行っています。安倍総理はあらゆる二国間、多国間の会談において必ず拉致問題を取り上げて、問題の深刻さ、我が国の取り組みに対する理解と支持、協力を要請してきました。
On the international front, we have also taken very strong initiatives to pursue this abductee issue. Prime Minister Abe, whenever he has a bilateral meeting, a summit meeting, or a multilateral meeting, he always invariably brings up the abduction issue. He stresses how important and serious this issue is for Japan and how determined our nation is to resolving this issue. He asks for the cooperation and support of his counterparts in resolving this issue.
共同宣言、会談後の共同宣言の中にも必ず拉致問題を含めています。
Whenever joint declarations are prepared, always the words abduction issue is included.
私も拉致問題担当大臣として、北朝鮮と国交を有しており、かつ我が国と友好関係にある国々との連携に取り組んできました。具体的にはモンゴル、ベトナム、ラオス、キューバ、等々といった国々を訪問しながら、拉致問題の協力要請をしてまいりました。
As State Minister in charge of the abduction issue, I have also visited various countries, and these countries are nations that have diplomatic relations with the DPRK and also who are friendly to Japan. Specifically, I have visited Mongolia, Vietnam, Laos, Cuba, and others. In this way, I have asked for the cooperation of our counterparts in these nations.
また、今年は国連を舞台とした大きな動きが進行しました。
I think many of you also are aware that many large initiatives or activities have taken place in the United Nations in this regard this year.
2月には拉致問題を含むいくつかの分野における北朝鮮による人権侵害が人道に対する罪に該当すると断定をする北朝鮮による人権に関する国連調査委員会、いわゆる COI でございますが、この報告書が公表されました。
In February of this year, a report was issued by a part of the UN. This is called a COI, or Commission of Inquiry, and the target of this inquiry, or this investigation, was human rights violations in the DPRK, including the matter of the abduction issues. And the report was issued in February, and the conclusion was that there were violations of human rights in the DPRK that could be deemed crimes against humanity.
この COI の報告書の作成にあたっては、日本政府としても関係諸国と連携をしながら、さまざまな形で関与、そして協力の要請を行ってきました。
In regard to the preparation of the COI report, a Commission of Inquiry report by the United Nations, the Japanese government took a very assertive participatory attitude. In other words, it asked for cooperation from various parties and it offered information. In other words, it took a very active part in helping to realize this report.
安倍総理自らも直接 COI のカービー委員長に、と会談を行い、詳細な説明を行いました。
Not only this, Prime Minister Abe himself met with the chair of this commission, Mr. Kirby, and he sat down with him and gave a very detailed explanation about this issue.
その会談は1時間以上に及びましたが、カービー委員長はその後に一国の総理からこのような詳細な説明を受けたことに驚いた。安倍総理の問題解決に向けた決意には尊敬の念を禁じ得ないと会見でおっしゃっていました。
The meeting between Prime Minister Abe and Mr. Kirby, the chair of the COI, lasted over an hour. And after the meeting ended, Mr. Kirby gave a press conference, and he explained that he was extremely surprised by the fact that the head of a nation, the Prime Minister of a nation, would spend this much time explaining a single issue, the abduction issue, in such great detail. He expressed a tremendous respect to the Prime Minister for his deep commitment to resolving this issue.
国連関係者でさえも政府認定の拉致被害者には認識がありましたが、860人、これだけの数の拉致被害者の可能性があるということを認識している人はほとんどいませんでした。
People who work for the United Nations or work in relationship with the United Nations, many of them did have some prior knowledge about the abductee issue. They also knew about the 17 persons who had been officially recognized by the Japanese government as abductees. However, most of them expressed tremendous surprise to hear that the number of people who were suspected of having been abducted reached 860. That number was astounding for many people.
だからこそカービー委員長の報告書には、キム・ジョン・ウンを直接非難をする、報告書、そして100人単位の拉致が行われたということをはっきり報告書に確認だったのです。
It is based on this increased understanding of the issue that Mr. Kirby's final report included some severe criticisms of the North Korean leader, Mr. Kim Jong-un.And also included the phrase that hundreds of people were suspected of having been abducted by the DPRK.
国連並びに国際社会に対してこの拉致問題への解決への機運は高まってきてますので、いかにこの国連総会にこういった問題をつなげていくかということが国際的には重要な課題であります。
As you can see, many related organizations with the United Nations or UN related organizations have begun to become very active in regard to the abductee issue. We would like very, very much to increase the momentum in this area and somehow bring it to fruition in the United Nations General Assembly.
この観点で、今月の10日に、スイスのジュネーブで北朝鮮による拉致を含む人権問題に関するシンポジウムを政府主催で開催をいたします。
So again, having the upcoming UN General Assembly meeting in mind, in October of this year, we are planning to hold a symposium in Geneva, in Switzerland, and it is a symposium about human rights violations by the DPRK, including the abduction issue.
1年8ヶ月の安倍内閣の取り組みによりまして、日朝間でも動きが始まりました。
As a result of the 1 year and 8 months administration of Prime Minister Abe, things are beginning to move between the two governments, the Japanese government and the North Korean government.
数字の日朝協議を得て、5月、北朝鮮側が拉致被害者および、拉致の可能性を排除できない行方不明者を含むすべての日本人に関する調査の実施を文書で約束をしました。
After many intergovernmental meetings between the Japanese government and the North Korean government, in May of this year, the DPRK promised in writing, in other words, they produced a document that promised that they would conduct investigations into all possible Japanese abductees, not only the officially recognized ones, but also all missing persons who are suspected of having been abducted.
7月には北朝鮮側がこの調査の実施のため、すべての機関を対象とした調査を行うことのできる特別の権限が与えられた特別調査委員会を立ち上げ、調査を開始すると、こう言明をしております。
DPRK government also announced that as of July, a new special investigation committee would be established. And this would be a very special investigative committee because they would have special authority to investigate all organizations, government and otherwise, in North Korea in order to resolve this issue.
北朝鮮は拉致問題については、5人の帰国をもって全て解決済みであって、今までは拉致の匂いも香りもしないと、もうこう言い続けてきました。しかし、 北朝鮮が今回このような対応をしてきた背景にはいくつかあります。
As you know, for many years, the DPRK has taken a very, very strong stance. They have been adamant that the five Japanese that were returned to Japan were the only surviving remaining abductees that still remained in North Korea. And in regard to any other possible Japanese that had been abducted and were in North Korea, there was not even a whiff or an aroma or smell of such people existing. However, as you can see, the North Korean government has taken a very, very different track now, and I think there are specific reasons that they have changed their stance.
この背景のは3つあると思います。まず1つはですね、やはり拉致問題について最も強い思いを持ち、北朝鮮に対して最も強い姿勢で臨んできた、そして最も詳しい国会議員である総理大臣が、政権が非常に安定した状況にあることが1つ目。
I think there are actually three reasons why the North Koreans have changed their stance. First of all, we now see that Prime Minister Abe is the head of the government, and this Mr. Abe is the Diet member in Japan who is most knowledgeable about this issue, who is most committed to resolving the abductee issue, and who has taken the very strongest stance towards the DPRK. The fact that he now leads a very stable government, I think, is one crucial factor in the change in the North Korean side.
2つ目は先ほど申し上げましたように国際社会の圧力が、高まってきたということ。
The second reason is, as I've explained, in the international community, there is increased pressure on North Korea to answer, respond to this issue.
3つ目は北朝鮮の指導者は若い指導者でございまして、自らは一切拉致問題に関与していないのが金正恩であります。
And the third reason is that the DPRK is now led by a new leader, and this is a very young person who has had no direct involvement in the abductee issue in the past. In other words, Mr. Kim Jong-un being in power is another factor why we're seeing a change.
彼は幼少の頃、西側社会、スイスで、住んで教育を受けたことがあります。
As you know, during his youth, he spent time in the West. He lived in Switzerland for a time, so he knows the West.
西側社会の空気を吸っているというのも事実です。
And he has actually breathed the air of Western society. He knows Western society best.
今後の展望についてでございますが、北朝鮮はやはり何度も我が国を、不誠実な態度を取って騙し続けてきました。
In regard to what I believe will happen in the future, as you know, in the past, the DPRK has repeatedly betrayed our trust and has tried to deceive us in the past.
しかし今回は、その環境の変化があるということを今私が申し上げた通りであります。
But as I mentioned earlier, the environment has changed.
だからこそ総理も少しの変化も見逃さずに果敢に協議に入っていく、ドアをこじ開けることが大切だと、こういうふうに主張しています。
So Prime Minister Abe has taken a very clear stance that even if there is an incremental, even a slight change, it should be taken advantage of. In other words, this slight change in the environment is an opportunity for us to get our foot in the door.
しかし北朝鮮は譲歩はほんの少し、奪い取るものはたくさんというのがあの国の性格であります。
However, the DPRK has had a long history of trying to give as little as possible and take as much as possible.
日本語で言うと、いよいよ胸突き八丁の競技が始まるということです。胸突き八丁というのはね、苦しい、山を登るとき苦しいけども、それに耐えて頑張るという。
There's a phrase in Japan that basically means that regardless of how difficult it is to climb a steep mountain, it is worth it because eventually things will get better.
で今、今後の展望についてはですね、北朝鮮が行っている、調査に関する最初の、報告が、夏の終わりから秋の初め頃に、出てくると、まあ、こういう共通認識は今持っています。
So, in regard to the future specifically, as was mentioned earlier, we are expecting the first report from the Special Investigation Committee. The common understanding we have between the two governments is that this report will be issued sometime around the end of summer to the beginning of fall.
まあこの調査がですね、どんなものになってくるのかということについては予断を許しません。
Of course, in spite of the changes that I've described, in regard to what exactly the contents of this first report will be, we cannot let up our vigilance. We do not know what will be produced.
この調査の過程における北朝鮮側の対応、そしてここで出てくる、中身はです。日本人の拉致問題の解決だけにとどまらず、ある意味北朝鮮における人権問題の改善解決についての、まあ、重要なテストであるということが言えると思います。
In regard to how exactly the Special Investigation Committee will proceed and in regard to the contents of the report that is actually produced, I believe this will be a very important test, a litmus test as to how serious the DPRK is in resolving this abductee issue. It is also a very, very important test in a larger sense because in a sense it shows, it will show how serious the DPRK is in resolving their overall human rights problems.
我が国としては北朝鮮がどんな中身を出してくるか等々についてあらゆるシミュレーションを想定をしてその対策に向けた準備を進めています。
Our nation is also prepared for whatever response is produced by the DPRK. In other words, we have prepared different scenarios for the different kinds of contents that first report might contain. And we have prepared different scenarios as to how we will respond. We've done different simulations.
今後、やはり日本人が大きな関心を持つこの拉致問題解決のために政府を挙げて名実ともにオールジャパンで取り組んでいくことを申し上げて冒頭の基調講演にさせていただきたいと思います。
So as you know, for the Japanese people, this abduction issue is a tremendous issue, a problem of concern, and I would like to end my speech by saying that the entire government, in other words, we would like to treat this as an all Japan initiative and to do everything in our power to resolve this issue quickly. Thank you.
はい、ありがとうございます。じゃあこれ最後。
Okay, without further ado, let's go into question and answers. The rules are the same as usual. Please state your name and affiliation and make your questions as short as possible. Working press first. I start with the first row here.
フランス店の記者の及川と申します。先月来、議論の的になっている慰安婦問題について伺いたいと思います。安倍首相は2007年4月27日ブッシュ大統領との共同記者会見で次のようにおっしゃいました。自分は辛酸をなめられた元慰安婦の方々に人間としてまた総理として心から同情するとともに、そうした極めて苦しい状況に置かれたことについて申し訳ないという気持ちでいっぱいであると、まあ、この発言を契機にしてアメリカ、そしてカナダ、オランダ、EU の議会で対日非難決議が採択されました。この辛酸をなめられた元慰安婦の方々に申し訳ないという発言は適切だったとお考えか、現在も踏襲すべきだとお考えか、ご意見伺えればと思います。
今のご質問は、いや、
すみません。So, very quickly, yes, I'd like to ask about the comfort women issue, which has been very much in the news recently. In 2007, on April 27th, there was a joint press conference between Mr. Bush and Mr. Abe. And in this press conference, Mr. Abe made the statement that in regard to the tremendous suffering that the comfort women experienced as a person, as a human being, and as a prime minister, I feel great sympathy. And I feel, and the Japanese word that is used is moshiwakenai, which is, I feel tremendously, it's tremendously.Regrettable that they suffered such a terrible situation, that they underwent such great suffering. Taking based on Mr. Abe's statement, many different governments and assemblies, beginning with the United States, Canada, and EU, passed resolutions condemning Japan for the comfort women issue. In regard to these phrases that were used, the sufferings of the comfort women and this term moshiwakenai, which in Japanese is a little difficult to translate because there's no subject that feel tremendous regret without specifying who. But in regard to this statement by Mr. Abe, do you think that is something that was appropriate and it is something that should be maintained as a statement?
今のご質問は、慰安婦問題についての政治の基本的立場はどうなのかという趣旨だと思いますので、そういった視点でお答えしますと、まあ、これまで歴史の中では多くの戦争がございました。その中で女性の人権が侵害をされてきたのも事実であります。21世紀こそ人権侵害のない世紀にすることが大切です。日本としても全力を尽くしたい考えです。
You've asked a question, I think that goes to the government's fundamental stance on the comfort women issue, so I would like to respond in kind. When we look at world history, we see that throughout the history of mankind, there have been wars in various parts of the world, and when these battles take place, it is a fact that women's rights have been violated, human rights of women have been violated. We now live in the 21st century, and we feel very strongly that this is a century where no one's human rights should be violated, and Japan and the Japanese government will do its best to ensure that such a century exists.
安倍総理は慰安婦問題についても施設に尽くしがたい辛い思いをされた方々のことを思い、非常に心を痛められております。この点についての思いは歴代総理と変わらないこと、何度も今まで述べられている通りであります。
Prime Minister Abe has expressed in the past his tremendous sympathy for the terrible sufferings of these comfort women. He says that his heart has been wounded when imagining the terrible sufferings that these women have had. And therefore, this expression of sympathy and pain is something that he has expressed as a prime minister. And it is also the same feelings that have been expressed by previous prime minister.
いずれにしても安倍内閣としてはこの問題を政治問題、外交問題化させるべきではないという考えであります。以上です。
Having said this, it is important to note that our Prime Minister Abe has taken a very clear stance that he does not wish to make this comfort women issue a political issue or a diplomatic issue. It should not be used for such purposes.
Christoph, please.
Süddeutsche Zeitung Neidhardt. You just explained why the abduction issue might be at a crucial moment. Now, if rumors are to be believed, the day after tomorrow you will lose your job as a minister. Does it make sense that the minister in charge is replaced in a crucial moment? And can you explain the motivation of the Prime Minister? Thanks.
南ドイツ新聞の記者でございます。今お話を聞いておりますと、その拉致問題は非常に重要な時期に来ているというふうにおっしゃってたと思うんでございます。しかしながら同時にいろんなその噂が飛んでおりますが、もしかしたら大臣は2日後に失職されるかもしれない、あるいはその拉致問題担当大臣からというポストから外されるかもしれないということでございますが、しかしながらこんなに重要なその時期に来ているこの問題を担当している大臣がこの時期に変わるということはあまりメイクセンスではないというふうに感じるんでございますが、安倍首相などの考えをどう思いますでしょうか。
今その今後3日以降どうなるんだという質問だと思うんですが、正直言って、人事権はすべて総裁にありますので、私からお答えするのは適切でないと思います。
So you're asking me what will happen two days from now. And as you know, all of the personnel decisions, all of the authority for making personnel decisions lies in the hands of the Prime Minister. As a result, I think it would not be appropriate for me to make any comments in this regard.
But I would like to follow up on this question because you've been in your position now for quite a long time, as the whole government has been. Before you, ministers for abduction changed so fast we couldn't keep track. The fact that you were in this position for 1 year and 8 months, did that help to bring the situation forward?
でもこの質問のフォローをさせていただきたいと思います。今回 の, その内閣は非常に長く、変わってないということでございます。昔はその拉致担当大臣もくるくる変わってた、というわけでございますが、やっぱり1年8ヶ月この、担当大臣をなさったということなんでございますが、この長くその大臣を務めたことがこの拉致問題の解決をなんて言うんですか、そのプロセスを、手伝ったと思いますでしょうか。
うん、よし、 いいですか、はい、その要素もあると思いますし、やはり安倍総理自身がですね、おそらく拉致問題裏も表も含めて一番詳しいんですよ。この内閣総理大臣が、自分の内閣の下で必ず拉致問題を解決すると、あれだけはっきり言明をしたということ、これはやっぱり北朝鮮としてもね、まあいい加減な形で、この拉致問題に蓋を閉めるということはできないと思っていることは間違いないと思います。
I think that is certainly one factor, the fact that I've been a state minister for so long. However, I think just as crucial, or even perhaps an important, more important aspect, is that, as I mentioned earlier, Prime Minister Abe is the Diet member that is most knowledgeable about the abduction issue. He knows it from frontwards and backwards completely thoroughly. And the fact that, as Prime Minister, he has taken a very, very clear and definitive stance and said very publicly that his administration is resolved, determined to solve this issue. And while he is in power, he wants to ensure that the abductee issue is moved forward. I think the fact that he's taken such a clear stance means that the DPRK cannot simply put a lid on this issue. It cannot take a half-hearted approach to this issue, but they must deal with it straight on.
私も安倍総理と、十数年間も20年近くにわたってこの問題を取り組んできた議員でございますので、やはり、そういったですね、内閣そして政党もですね、同じ考えなんですね。この拉致問題については圧力をかけることによって初めて北朝鮮は少しずつ譲歩してくる、だから融和作戦は絶対ダメなんだっていう、もう確固たるスタンスは政党も安倍総理もこの政府ももちろん私拉致担当大臣も全く変わりがない。これがやはり、少しずつ拉致の協議を動き始めた要素であることは間違いないと思います。
I have been working with Prime Minister Abe on this issue for almost 20 years, and the fact that we are all, as I mentioned, all Japan, but the government and the cabinet and the political party that we represent, we all think along the exact same lines. We are all unwavering in our belief that the only way to obtain a response from the DPRK is to apply unrelenting pressure. It is only by applying this continual pressure that they will start releasing information and giving way. In other words, to take a soft-hearted approach is not something that is going to be effective. And this is something that I said as earlier that the entire government is in agreement on. I'm sorry, the word that was being used was we do not believe in an appeasement policy.
Okay. Now, please. Yes.
Hello, my name is Crowell with Nuclear Intelligence Weekly. How many, if any, of the 860 suspected abductees had the skills to be able to help North Korea with its nuclear weapons program?
その、原子核インテリジェンス、まあ、週刊でしょうか、ウィークリーという雑誌のものでございますが、今860人がその、もしかしたらその拉致されたかもしれないということだったのでございますが、この860人のうち、その、原子核、この分野について知識を持っているような方は何人いらっしゃいましたでしょうか。つまり原子核、あるいはその核兵器などについて知識を持っておりました方たちは何人ぐらいいらっしゃると思いますでしょうか。つまり北朝鮮のその核プログラムに貢献できそうな人たちは何人ぐらいいらっしゃったと思いますでしょうか。
860人の内訳はですね、いろんな職業の方がいらっしゃいます。でその中にどういう職業であったか、具体的に何だったかっていうのは、ある意味ではちょっとインテリジェンスの部分にも入りますので、その具体的にその何人いたかっていうことは、ここでお答えすることはできません。しかし、ホームページに少なくとも443人は公開をされています。しかし、元の職業が何だったかっていうところまでは書いていません。どこで拉致をされた、そして拉致された時はいくつだったと、まあ、こういう情報は出しています。
In regard to the 860 people, there were people of various occupations that were abducted. However, and if I were to give you a specific breakdown about what these former occupations were of these people, that would really go into the intelligence realm. And as a result, I cannot give you specific numbers about what people were or had or what specific occupations. On our homepage, as I mentioned earlier, there is more detailed information about 443 of these 860 people. However, in regard to what occupations they held previously, that kind of information is unfortunately not on that homepage either. It's more the names, where they were suspected of having been abducted, the age they were at the time of the abduction.
ちょっといいですか。この443名を公開することによる効果はすごくあります。
I would like to take a moment to talk a little bit about these 443 people whose information we have released to the public.
なぜか30年以上前のケースもあるんですが、しかし皆さん小さい頃の記憶ってすごく覚えてますよね。ですから場合によってはですね、そのホームページを見た方が、あ、このもしかしてこのケースじゃないかって気がついて思い出して、実は警察に連絡をしてきていただけるケースって結構あるんです。でその情報によって、このいわゆる拉致の可能性を排除できない事案の精度が上がっていくんです。
The reason is that some of the information about these 443 people is very old. In other words, some of the people who are suspected of having been abducted were abducted over 30 years ago. However, it's a funny thing about human nature. People remember things more clearly when it is a memory from their childhood or from very, very long ago. And by releasing this information to the public, it may sometimes stimulate people's memories, and it may bring specific... remembrances to their minds and prompt people to go to the police with this information. What I'm saying is that by releasing more specific information about these 443 people, we have been able to raise the accuracy level, in other words, about the information that we have on these potential or possible abductees.
Yes, Siegfried, please.
Siegfried Knittel, freelancer from Germany. The Japanese government lifted some sanctions against North Korea to get some, to improve the negotiation climate to North Korea. I think this is against the policy of the United States. United States is strongly says no lift of sanctions before North Korea doesn't abolish nuclear weapons. How do you explain the United States, the Japanese position?
ドイツのフリーのものでございます。以前、日本政府の方は独自に課しておりました制裁の一部を解除されたということでございます。それによってより良い雰囲気を作るということでございますね。その交渉を容易にするためにということなんでございます。しかしながらこれは米国の、その、体制と非常に違うわけでございます。米国はやっぱり北朝鮮側がその核プログラムを放棄しない限り一切制裁を解除しないということでございます。この日本と米国が違う態度、違うその政策を取っているということについてどう思いますでしょうか。
ちょっとこれは丁寧に説明した方がいいと思います。少し回答が長くなることを許してください。
So I'd like to apologize in advance. This explanation, this response is going to be quite long because this is something that I should explain very, very carefully, all the details.
まず日本が課している制裁は国連決議に基づく制裁と日本独自の制裁、2つがあります。
In regard to the sanctions that Japan has imposed on North Korea, there are two types. One is a group of sanctions that are in line with UN resolutions, UN Security Council resolutions, and the other are sanctions that have been unilaterally just by Japan imposed upon North Korea.
今度は一部の制裁を解除しましたが、これはあくまでも日本が独自に行っている制裁の一部解除です。
And yes, as you've pointed out, we have lifted some sanctions, but these are sanctions that were unilaterally imposed upon North Korea by Japan.
この制裁はですね、3点あります。一つは人の往来の禁止の一部解除、再入国禁止措置の解除です。二つ目が人道目的の、 船舶の入港の解除、3つ目が、送金金額あるいは、携帯金額、携行金額の、届け出の、バーを低くするということ。
There are specific sanctions, three specific sanctions that we have lifted. One has to do with the comings and goings of people between the two nations. In other words, the re-entry into Japan for some people has been, the ban has been removed. Secondly, in regard to the ships coming into Japanese ports, if the reasons for their coming to Japan have to do with humanitarian reasons, the ban on those ships has now been lifted. They can come to Japanese ports. And the third has to do with the amount of money that is being either sent from North Korea to Japan or vice versa, or being carried between the two countries. The amount that has to be declared, if you go above a specific amount of money, then you have to declare it. But that amount level has beenlowered. The bar has been lowered.
もうちょっと詳しく言いますと、最初の人の往来、これは無原則に往来ができるわけではありません。厳しい審査を行うことが、従前通りであります。
I would like to explain in a little bit more detail in regard to the first lifting of sanctions that I mentioned, where it is easier for people to move between the two countries. It doesn't mean that anyone can immediately come into the country. We are maintaining a very strict screening processes as we have in the past.
再入国を禁止されることを禁止しましたけど、この対象は実質的に9人なんです。それは朝鮮総連の、ホジョンマンはじめ、5名は、北朝鮮の代議員、国会議員をしています。この5名とそのサブの4名、9名、これが具体的な、の人数ですよ。
In regard to the lifting of sanctions about that have specifically, what was done is that the re-entry process, there was a ban on certain people being able to re-enter Japan. But that ban only applied to 9 individuals. Five were individuals that have that had posts in Soren, which is the Korean Residents Association of Japan, if that is correct. And these five individuals and their sort of lieutenants, 4 lieutenants. So it only applied to these 9 individuals. And now that ban on their re-entering Japan has been lifted.
2つ目の人道支援の船舶の入港は貿易を、認めるわけではありません。
And in regard to the lifting of the ban on ships coming into Japanese ports, as I mentioned earlier, it is only for humanitarian reasons that we have lifted the ban. If their primary purpose is to engage in trade, then they are still subject to the ban.
ですから、例えば北朝鮮は寒い国ですから、例えば、コートを10枚、送るとかですね、セーターを10枚。持っていくとか、そういう極端なことを言うと、これは郵便物でも送ることが可能です。
So, I mean, just to give you some examples, as you know, the DPRK is a nation that has a very, very cold climate. So when we talk about humanitarian reasons, if one wants to ship 10 coats or take 10 sweaters, then we are allowing that. To give an extreme example, these are the kinds of things that actually could be sent by post.
3番目は、携行金額と送金金額のバーを下げた。これは申告をすれば今でも解除前でもやれますので。
解除前でも、
債の一部解除前でも申告をすればやれますから。
And I also wanted to explain in regard to that third point about lowering the bar for the amount of money that has to be reported. If you're sending a certain amount of money or carrying a certain amount of money, even before this ban was lifted, if you made a report, declared this money, it was still possible to send and carry that money.
もう一つはアメリカとの関係ですね。
And so your question really has to do with the relationship between Japan and the United States on this matter.
私たちの日本の政府の、拉致問題に関する関係は北朝鮮に関する基本方針は拉致核ミサイルを包括的に解決をする、これが基本方針です。
In regard to the Japanese government, its fundamental stance in regard to North Korea is that we seek a comprehensive solution of issues outstanding between the two nations. In other words, a comprehensive solution to the nuclear missiles issue and also the abductee issue.
しかし日本は、北朝鮮は拉致問題というこの国民の大きな関心事の問題を抱えているのも事実です。
But at the same time, I am sure you understand that for the Japanese people, the abductee issue is a tremendous issue, something that is of tremendous concern.
去年、日本政府主催でニューヨークとワシントンで、拉致問題のシンポジウムを開催をいたしました。
Last year, under the auspices of the Japanese government, we held two symposiums, one in New York and one in Washington, D.C., on this issue.
国連関係者、そして国務省関係者、アメリカの政府関係者も多数出席をしました。
Many members of the United Nations, many members of the State Department of the United States attended these symposiums.
そこで日本は拉致核ミサイルを包括的に解決するっていうのが日本の基本スタンスだが、日本は拉致問題を抱えているので、交渉の入り口において、二国間で主体的にこの拉致問題の協議をすることはあり得るんだ、これをすることが結果として、核あるいはミサイル問題についての解決の端緒となってくるんだ、まあ、こういう説明をして、国務省の関係者、米国政府も理解を示しています。
During these symposiums, we were very, very clear about the stance of the Japanese government that, again, we sought a comprehensive solution to the outstanding issues between the DPRK and other nations. Specifically, in regard to Japan and the DPRK, we had the nuclear issue, the missiles issue, and also the abductee issue. Therefore, we also explained to our counterparts in the State Department, members of the U.S. government, that it would be possible that the Japanese government could use the abductee issue as an implement to somehow begin negotiations with the DPRK. And as a result of our being able to start negotiations on this issue with the DPRK, the final end result might be that we would be able to find an opening so that we would be able to have negotiations so we could resolve the other outstanding issues, in other words, the nuclear program, missiles issue as well. And we were able to gain the understanding of our counterparts in the State Department.
このことはその後もですね、米国関係者、政府関係者が来たときには伝えておりまして、理解をもらってます。
And not only at the symposium, but in other meetings that we have had subsequently with members of the U.S. government when they come to Japan, for example, we have always taken the opportunity to explain our fundamental stance, and we have always been able to gain the understanding of our counterparts in the United States.
ちなみに今回のですね、この一部の、制裁解除についても、公表前に事前にアメリカには通知をいたしております。
And just to be clear, before we lifted some of the sanctions that we had unilaterally imposed upon North Korea, before we did this, we did make before the official announcement, we did convey our intentions to the U.S. government.
以上です。
Thank you.
Yes, so this was a very long answer. I just got a note that we could extend 10 minutes. Is that okay with you?
10 minutes, okay. 10
okay,
minutes.
Please.
Yes. I have another meeting starting at 6:30, so I have about 10
minutes. 10 minutes is okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah. ありがとうございます。エコーニュースの江藤と申します。昨年公表されたその860人分 の拉致被害の可能性が排除できない事案についてですが、これは公表が昨年になってしまったのはなぜでしょうか。日本政府はそれまでこの事案のことを把握していなかったのでしょうか。それともあるいは何らかの事情、遠慮ですとか外交カードで使いたいとかといった理由で、知ってたけれど公表を控えてたんでしょうか。例えば、発表しようと思えば安倍内閣の、第一次安倍内閣の時にもできたけど、それをあえてやらなかったということでしょうか。よろしくお願いします。
I'd like to ask about the report about the 860 people that was announced by last spring. Why was this information not released or officially beforehand? In other words, were you trying to use this information as a kind of diplomatic card, a negotiating tool, or was you refraining from releasing this information out of sympathy to the families, etc.? In other words, it might have been possible that during the first Abe administration, this information could have been released, but it was not. Why?
まずこの安倍内閣になって私の国家公安委員長としての決断でこれを公表するということを決めさせていただきました。
First of all, I'd like to explain that with the current Prime Minister's Abe's administration, with my having taken on the mantle of the State Minister for National Public Security Matters, National Public Safety Commission, excuse me, it was my decision as minister in charge of this responsibility to release this information.
その前にですね、野党あ政権交代があって3年3ヶ月間、我々は野党でしたんで、この間の事情については分かりません。
In regard to the previous administrations before that, in other words, for the 3 years and 3 months when we were the opposition parties, I really cannot speak on behalf of the government at that time.
第一次安倍内閣の時になぜしなかったことについては、実は私その時郵政問題で造反をして無所属でおりましたので、事情は詳しくわかりません。
And so I cannot speak for the government at that time. And in regard to your question, why was this not announced or made public during the first Abe administration? I must explain that at that time, this was a time of postal privatization, and there was an election. And because I voted against what the government wanted to do, I was basically had to leave the party, and I ran as an independent. So I really cannot speak about what was going on in the government at that time.
Yes, please.
こんにちは。講談社の週刊現代記者の久保山と申します。お世話になります。先ほどの話で北朝鮮の拉致特別調査委員会の結果報告が夏の終わりから秋の頭というふうにおっしゃいましたけど、具体的な日程が決まってたらちょっと教えていただきたいのと、あと日朝の政府間協議の場所ですね、行われる場所、第三国か平壌かっていうふうに言われて、もしと最後に調査結果ですね、拉致被害者の名前がなかった場合、政府としてはどういった対応をされるか、この3点をちょっと教えていただければと思います。
So, I'm from Kodansha. In regard to the report that you were expecting from the Special Investigation Committee, do you have, first of all, three questions. One, do you have a specific dates, if you are able to tell us when this report will be coming? And secondly, in regard to the intergovernmental negotiations that will be taking place, will this be taking place in Pyongyang or a third country? And thirdly, if the specific names of abductees are not included in this final, in this first report, what will be the response of the Japanese government?
まず日時ですけど、これは決まっていません。まだそういった細かい数値はありません。
In regard to, In regard to the specific dates, nothing has yet been decided.
場所も決まっていません。
The location of the, meetings have also not been decided.
それと3番目の拉致被害者がいなかった場合どうするのかという趣旨の質問ですけども、まあ、これはですね、あらゆることを想定をして、頭の体操、シミュレーションをしております。ここまでは申し上げられますが、具体的にこういう場合っていうのは、これはある意味でちょっとインテリジェンスに関わる分なんで、お答えは差し替えさせていただきます。
In regard to your third question, I think the intent of your question is basically what if the Special Investigation Committee says that there were no abductees that were found. As I mentioned earlier in my speech, we have done mental exercises, in other words, created very, very many different scenarios about the possible responses, the contents of that first report. And we have created many possible responses for each of these scenarios. But for me to go into further detail about this would really encroach in the territory of intelligence, so I must refrain from making more specific comments.
But having increased this number to 860, is it possible that North Korea can give an answer the Japanese public accepts? Because the bar is now very, very high.
That they can or can't?
That they can.
そうですね、860名という非常に大きな数字になったわけでございますので、この数字が大きくなっただけに北朝鮮側が日本国民が納得できるような返答をできるようになったと思われますでしょうか。
北朝鮮側が
、日本国民が納得できるような、お答えというのか返事を出せるような状況になったと思いますでしょうか。860名が対象になっておりますので、
拉致問題人数については私たちは最大限で860人と言ってます、そして拉致したのは北朝鮮そのものでありますから、ボールは北朝鮮側にあります。
First of all, in regard to the numbers, the maximum number of people that we consider to have been potentially or possibly abducted by the North Koreans is 860. And I would like to reiterate that these abductions were implemented on the part of the DPRK. In other words, it was a deliberate act. As a result, we believe that the ball is now in their court. So again, I will reiterate the Japanese government's fundamental position, which is that we will do everything in our power to retrieve every single one of these abductees.
だからこそどういう報告書が来るかっていうのは私たちはあらゆる状況を想定をして今それを待っているというところです。
So again, this may be a repetition, but we have implemented every possible scenario so that we will be able to deal with whatever response DPRK might produce.
But by definition, every document, every proof will come out of North Korean authorities. The Japanese side has been cheated before, has been deceived before. How can you believe now that you get...The true information.
しかしながら、この問題を、よく、考えますと、すべての資料、すべての証拠というのは北朝鮮側が、提出するものでございます。まあ、先ほどのお話にございましたように、今までも、日本政府は騙されてきた、まあ信じられないようなその証拠とか、その資料を、出されてきたわけでございますが、今回も同じようなことにならないというその保証がありますでしょうか。
私5月の22日に、日朝協議が、の10年を、節目にですね、私は、自分の談話を出しております。でこれは5月22日と言いますと26日から28日まで、ストックホルムで日朝協議が始まる1週間前に出しております。そしてその中身で出したところで、まあ、2枚ぐらいの談話なんですが、ポイントだけ申し上げますと、我々は、徹底的に、情報を、調査して収集をしてきました。そして、北朝鮮が今までと同じような、不誠実な態度をとっても、これは北朝鮮をもう取り返しのつかない状況に追い込むだけであります。日本がそういった中途半端な中身でですね、国民が納得をすることは 100% ないです。だから北朝鮮はしっかりその調査をしなさいと。それからもう一方、この拉致問題で、誠実な対応を示すことが結果として北朝鮮の尊厳も回復することになるし、そして、その他の拉致、核・ミサイル問題についてもですね、取り組んでいく。端緒になるのです。きっかけになるのであります。だから、ぜひ若い指導者のキム・ジョンウンはしっかりその決断をすべきであるということをはっきり私たちは謳っております。これは政府で、綿密なすり合わせをした上でこういった談話を出しています。
On May 22nd, as State Minister in charge of the abduction issue, I issued a statement. It was a two-page statement, it was about my thoughts as State Minister on the occasion of the 10th anniversary of the beginning of negotiations between the Japanese government and the DPRK government. And as I mentioned, this statement was issued on May 22nd, and it was basically about almost a week before the negotiations in Stockholm between the two governments were going to take place. They were scheduled for May 26th to 28th. And I'm not going to go into detail about it, but the statement has several points. One is that the Japanese government has already done everything in its power to collect as much information, investigation, and collect as much information on its own as possible. Secondly, if the DPRK were to show an insincere attitude, as it has in the past, it may find itself put into an untenable position. In other words, the Japanese people are not prepared to accept a half-baked response. I can speak with certainty, 100% certainty, that the Japanese people will not accept such insincere response. So, in other words, I was asking the DPRK to truly, sincerely conduct its investigations. And I also said in my statement that if the investigations are done in a truly sincere manner, then the North Koreans would have an opportunity to regain their dignity. In other words, by dealing with this matter in a very sincere and wholehearted way, it might be that they would be able to find the opportunity to resolve some of their other outstanding problems, in other words, the nuclear problem and the missiles problem. And therefore, as State Minister, I urge the new young leader to be bold in his decision-making. And although I said this was my statement as State Minister, this statement was produced after very careful deliberations within the government.
Okay, our 10 minutes extra time have run out. Thank you very much. We have a little tradition here that we give a one-year honorary membership to all our speakers. So if the rumors should become true and you lose your job in 2 days, you have a place to come and find some consolation.
Thank you very much.
Please wait until the minister has quit this. Yes, thank you very much.